Welcome students. In today's class, we will study about welded joints which are subjected to torsional moment. Consider a shaft of length L and diameter D welded to this support by means of this circumferential weld. This shaft is subjected to a torque T. Now, let us derive the relation of shear stress which will be induced when the shaft is subjected to torque T. From the figure, we can see that when this shafts rotate or when torque is applied to this shaft, it will produce a shear stress on this circular weld. This weld will get rubbed off with the shaft. Hence, we can say that this weld will be failing by shear, or shear stress will be induced on this weld. Now, let us derive the relation of the shear stress induced on this weld. From basic relation, I have stress is equal to force upon area. But in this, we are not given the force, we are given torque. So let us now convert this force in terms of torque. So we also know that force is equal to torque divided by radius. Or we can say torque is equal to force multiplied by radius. So I will get here, in place of F, I will write T divided by R, that is torque divided by R multiplied by area. Multiplying and dividing by R, I will get T multiplied by R divided by R square into A. This term R square into A is the second moment of area, or we can also say it as polar moment of inertia. So replacing this R square into A by polar moment of inertia, that is J, I will get is equal to T into R divided by J. Hence the relation tau is equal to T into R divided by J, which we also use as a torsion equation. Substituting the required values in this equation, I will get tau is equal to T multiplied by R, can be written as D by 2 divided by R square will be D by 2 the whole square multiplied by area. Area of the shear. So from this diagram, we can see that this weld will shear along the circumference. So circumference will be pi D multiplied by the thickness of the weld at throat, because we know that welds always fail from the throat point. So the area of this weld will be pi D, that is circumference, multiplied by T. So replacing area by pi into D into T. On simplifying this equation, I will get 2T divided by pi into T into D square. This T is throat of the weld. If I need to convert this into the size of the weld, that is H, I need to write T is equal to 0.707 into H. Tau is equal to 2T divided by pi. T will be written as 0.707 into H multiplied by D square. On simplifying this equation further, I will get tau is equal to 2.83 T divided by pi into H into D square. I got the expression as the shear stress induced in a circular fillet weld for a shaft subjected to pure torsion as 2.83 T divided by pi H into D square. This is the equation which we are going to use while solving the problems. This equation I have derived just for your knowledge purpose, that how this equation comes. You can use this equation directly from PSG, that is design data book, page number 11.3. Let us try to apply the relation in the given problem. The problem says a circular shaft 50 mm in diameter is welded to a support by means of a circumferential weld. It is subjected to a torsional moment of 2500 Nm. Determine the size of the weld if shear stress permissible is 140 Nm/mm². By reading the question, we have identified that this is a problem of a circumferential weld when subjected to purely a torsional moment. Starting with the solution of this problem. Now we have derived the relation that for this case, tau will be is equal to 2.83 T divided by pi into h into d square. And we can also write it is a standard relation from PSG 11.3. Substituting the values which are known to us, tau is given to us as 140, 2.83 multiplied by T. The torsional moment is given to us as 2500 Nm. Most of the students make mistake here. The unit is Newton meter and we are working in Newton mm. So we need to convert this. So it will be 2500 into 10 raised to 3 divided by pi into h is unknown multiplied by diameter is given to us as 50 mm. On solving this expression, I will get h is equal to 6.43 mm. Or I can write h, that is size of the weld, is approximately equal to 7 mm. This completes the solution. Let us solve one more question on this type. The question is, a 50 mm diameter solid shaft is welded to a flat plate by 10 mm circular fillet. Find maximum torque that the weld joint can sustain if tau max not to exceed 80 MPa. From the question, we have identified that there is a circular fillet weld and it has been applied with a torque. So again, it's the same case. So in solution, I will write my first step as tau is equal to 2.83 T divided by pi into h into d square. And this relation I got from PSG 11.3. Substituting the given values, tau is given to us as 80, 2.83, t is unknown, pi into size of the weld is given as 10 mm into diameter is given as 50 mm. On solving this equation, I will get the value of T as 2.22 into 10 raised to 6 Newton mm. Or if I want to convert it, I can write T is equal to 2.22 kilo Newton meter. This completes the solution.